My name is Jeff Bruggink, and I'm the regional soil scientist for the Forest Service here in Ogden, Utah. Water trailer is a model of a complete watershed, everything from the top of the mountains all the way down to the bottom of the valley or reservoir. And what it does is it really shows how watershed works. It shows how stream systems work within a watershed. I got habitats for them. We've got homes. We have all of this vegetation next to the river, just all the trees along the river behind us. This is a model of all these trees. And we can show various scenarios. It's eroding pretty fast. It is very dangerous, because there's no way I can protect my house anymore. My water is probably the most important resource to maintain healthy populations of people, as well as native populations of plants and animals. Everything's connected by water and soil. So what we want to do here with this watershed is show that connection. What did you say?
The reservoir's really dirty.
Did you guys hear that? The reservoir is getting really dirty. Who's got to pay to clean out all that water?
We do.
We do. It's a great tool to be able to show all ages of the public what we do as an agency, to show them a little bit of what they can do as stewards of the landscape in partnership with us. And it gives them an opportunity to understand some of the processes that take place, neither whether it's wrong stream channels or with riparian habitats, wetland habitats. It gives them an idea of how things actually work in a watershed and why it's so important to conserve resources within a watershed. Some of the basic resources that we depend upon every day are derived from watersheds. Our soil resources, our water resources, just land that we live and walk on. All those resources are part of keeping us as healthy environments, provide resources for us to go on a day-by-day basis. So we all need to take a part in protecting those watersheds. And do you see those mountains way up there? That's actually National Forest Service land. You know who owns that? Any clue? You guys do. What we've been seeing is that our youth, as far as the future, I feel that they're the most influential conservationists of the future. If we can show them some of the things that we know as land managers, the youth will be the ones that are supporting land management agencies in the future. And I think it's worth the time and the effort and the resources at that age right now to ensure that we have support for these public lands in the future.